Hello, everyone, and welcome to some Tuesday night basketball by the Bay. We have Palo Alto and Lynbrook here on MC Sports. We have the Battle of the Vikings, the Lynbrook Vikings. They are 63 in the state of California, taking on the host Pali Vikings. They're 146. We have a great matchup for you here in Palo Alto. Hey, everyone, I'm Kieran Costa along with Austin May, and we just can't wait for this one to get underway. We have the Palo Alto Vikings, 10-4. They're undefeated in the league, coached by Scott Peters. And then Lynbrook, they traveled from San Jose here to Palo Alto. They're 13-2, 4-0 in league, and as we said earlier, 63rd in the state of California. Palo Alto coming off a big statement win last Friday against their rival, the Gun Titans, are led by Carly Martin and Kayla Peters. Kayla Peters, a freshman. There are a lot of freshmen on this Palo Alto Vikings team. Kayla Peters, Vivian Wu, Itzel Torres, and Delaney Ball and Julia Hayden. We have the sisters as well on this Pali team, the Turgut sisters. They, we have Layata Turgut and Elif Turgut, those two for Palo Alto. And here's Austin, just to give you a quick preview for this Lynbrook team.
This Lynbrook team has got a lot of lower classmen, a lot of sophomores, a lot of juniors. It looks like they can be good for years to come because they're going to have these players for a couple another years. And they're in CCS Division II, ranked 63rd in the state. I think they're going to be really good and have been really good. Led by Coach Lindley Takai. And then their captains, Jessica Admaja, excuse me if I mispronounced that, and Lydian Lee, playing point guard, and Jessica Admaja.
Yeah, we are in for a good one. We have this game coming to you here from Vikings Gymnasium. This is the first day of a back-to-back for Lynbrook women's basketball. They play tomorrow, and as we said, Pali coming off that win against their rivals. And a win against your rival always means a lot. We were at the game, of course, on Friday. They got a big win against their rival Gun Titans. They went in there and shut that place up. The crowd was a big factor in that one. Austin, what do you think this home crowd can do for the Vikings looking to pull off a little bit of an upset?
I think the crowd can be a big factor, especially during free throws, try and rattle the opponent, get them off their game early, as Palo Alto, as being ranked about 60 spots lower in the state rankings, really need to come out fast, come out early, and get on top. As if they fall behind, I don't know if this crowd can stay in it and keep them and will them to a win.
As Lynbrook is red hot coming in, they have won 7 straight and all in statement fashion, taking down Newark Memorial by 20, Wilcox by 13, Wheeland by 15. Presentation, the closest game they've played, that was a 10-point win. They beat Los Altos, that one hurts for me, and then Cupertino, the huge win by 27. And they beat Los Gatos 4 days ago. Their next game against Saratoga, Parker, and then they come to Los Altos High School. And so their 2 losses were given to them by American and Sequoia. That Sequoia game was 8 games ago as they're on that hot streak, and they lost that one by 9 and losing to American by 6. So even when they lose, they're not by a lot. Austin, if a team just in the game the whole time, how does it affect the opponent, knowing that this team will be in a close game every time?
It shows you, like, especially since they're coming off that hot streak, that they know how to win in the clutch. When it comes down to it, they have the players that know how and where they're supposed to be. They're ready to execute, and it really shows you that if they're in a close game, it could easily give them advantage just because of the experience they've had. Whereas Pali has not been in all these close games this year, and they've basically been kind of up and down.
Yeah, they, as you said, Pally's been here before, and that's something that really takes it out of an opponent. Like, even if you're leading late, you cannot get too comfortable. This team has, this Lynbrook team has been there a lot. They, of course, Mason Yee and Lydia Lee there, or Jessica Admajana and Lydian Lee, those are two juniors leading the charge as they are captaining. And just to recap the schedule, this Pally team has not been too shabby either, 10-4. And they're also red hot coming in. They've won six games, including that huge win. We were on the call last Friday as they held Gunn under 20 points. Their losses have been a little bigger though, losing to Presentation by 11 Aptos. That Aptos one was a killer. They lost by one in overtime. But they've won six straight, taking down Cupertino, MA, Los Gatos, Saratoga, Wilcox, and as I said, Gunn. They play Los Altos on Friday. We are under 5 minutes till tip, and we're in for a good one. Of course, Coach Scott Peters, a great coach. He's coached a lot. But here in the standings, we have Palo Alto. This is a in-division game, a big one. We cannot wait for this one. A lot of implications for both teams.
Yeah, this is a big game as both of these teams come in at the top of the league, both undefeated in league play, duking it out to get the top spot in the league and have sole possession of that spot.
But what we saw a lot with Pally last game was the size advantage. They have, of course, the 6 foot Inosh, Hayden 6'1", 5'10 Fisk, and of course 6'3", Ayata Turgut. She's the center. She struggled shooting the ball, but was grabbing almost every single board.
I think one of the big keys in this game could be the rebounding factor. When you're playing against a greater opponent, you really need to control the boards, because if you can control the boards, you can control the possessions and kind of take the game at your own pace. If they get Lynbrook's able to take control of the boards, they can move at a faster pace, maybe tire Pally out. I think that's going to be a big factor in this game, and Pally has the advantage there with the couple of six-footers.
Pally's star, Monica Shaw, we saw her last year, but she is really banged up this year. We see her, she's out there right now talking to Coach Scott Peters, and she has a brace on her lower leg. She was amazing when we saw her last year. She controlled the game. Let's see what Pally can do without their star. Lynbrook finish up their warm-ups, and they head to their bench. Coach Tayak Takaki will talk to them. But I think this one will come down to, with two great coaches, I think it's about the captaining. Lee and, of course, Carly Martin, Jessica Fisk are the leaders of this Pally team. And that says a lot when your leaders are freshmen. Kayla Peters played almost all of last game, and she started as a freshman. You don't see that a lot. You do not see that a lot as a freshman starting on varsity. But we are in for a good one. The teams go to their benches, and we will get the starting lineups in just a minute here.
Yeah, with about a minute and a half till tip, I think the captains are going to be really important in this game, and I think it's when you're a freshman captain, it really shows you demand the respect of your teammates. You've earned that, because it's not very easy coming in as a first-year player to say, I am the leader of this team, and that's what Pally's freshman captain has been able to do. We got tip-off coming up in about a minute and 15 seconds.
As I think this will be big for Pally. It should be a good game. We got two almost closely ranked teams, and I think this Coach Peters talk at the start of this one will be crucial. What is he telling his team right now, Austin? Coming in, they are not favored to win. The other team's a little better, but Coach Peters and this team knows they're a good basketball team, and they can definitely win this game.
I think he's telling them basically stick to your basics. When you're playing against another team, they're going to try and complicate things. They're going to try and confuse you. As long as they stick to their basics, they should be fine. And basically, you know, just try and take it at their own pace and not get caught up in their game. Because once you get caught up in their game, they can stretch the game out, take it over, and possibly run away with this thing.
As the starters on the floor for the Vikings, Peters, Martin, Fisk, along with Delaney Ball and Elif Turgut. And for Lynbrook, we'll give you those in just a minute. But it's time for tip here in Palo Alto. Fisk against Ho for the jump ball. We will real quick give you the Lynbrook starters. Jessica Amadaji, the captain. They have Lydian Y, another captain. Madison Yee, Haley Yee, and then in the center, Sarah Ho. We have Ho and Fisk. The jump will be up in just a second. Fisk has the height advantage. It's up and controlled by Palo Alto.
Yeah, we saw them really get up there and use that height advantage early.
Three ball, no good. And rebound controlled by Palo Alto. Well played outside. Turgut has a man in the corner. Keeps dribbling, taken away. Right down Broadway. Pulls it back, goes to the corner. Gets to the cup, thrown, picked off by the Vikes.
That was a really good play by the Pally center there to intercept the pass and get in the lane.
Peters tries a three, no good. Rebound taken by Turgut. Goes out to Ball.
What I'm noticing from Pally is they're trying a lot of motion to see if they can confuse the defense and maybe get a person open.
Taken away, just taken right out of her hands by Lydian Y. Euro step to the cup, layup just a bit short. Nice move, just couldn't finish.
Lindbergh's trying to press him here and trap. They got him in the corner, but Pally was able to get out of it.
Pally had the press beat. They just could not make that pass. Peters. And, fake handoff to Martin. Goes to Turgut. Tries to drive. Outside Delaney Ball.
I think Pally really needs to take it inside. They have a huge height advantage with their forward and their center. And that could be...
Martin, nice move to the cup, and she finishes. Vikes by two early.
Lynbrook trying to push the pace by passing it down the court.
They've gotten to the cup, just missed a shot, and had a silly turnover. Peters up off the bench to the corner. They're running a five out, and the ball movement looks great. Layup no good.
That was a really good box out by number 10 on Palo Alto.
Fisk with a nice box out. We missed the shot. Three ball for Martin. Could not get it. Rebounded by Turgut. This is what they did against Gunn. Let's see if they can do it here, win this rebound battle.
Number 10's really boxing or set, backing her down in the post. I think they really need to feed her down there. She's got a huge height advantage and could get easy layups.
Turgut pump fakes, get to the cup, open layup, good. Elif Turgut drives and scores.
Palo Alto by four early.
Pally bringing the press, not as strong as Lynbrook though. And it's been there in the backcourt. That could have been an over and back call. No call.
Pally switching very well early as they're not letting Lynbrook get any open shots.
Y tries a triple, buried it.
Pally.
Beg your pardon, that was Hylael Lee Yee.
Pally's really trying to get a lot of movement with some screens, trying to get in the lane. Again, use that height advantage.
Martin wanted a foul, didn't get it. Three ball from Turgut. She can't answer. Martin gets the layup and scores. And all the whole defense had a head on her. Breakaway for Lynbrook. Layup good.
That was a really good slowdown to get it under control so she didn't miss the open layup.
A deep pass. Peters to Martin. Martin can't finish. Gets her own rebound, tries again, and scores. Pace, lots of scoring.
I really like right now what Pally's trying to do by pushing the pace and basically forcing Lynbrook into bad positions, trying to get them to over-rotate and leave open players in the lane for easy layups.
Yeah, we see Peters and Martin moving the ball very well early. Takaki wanted timeout. And it's a good timeout call. She's down three, but she could see that the pace was getting away from her.
Yeah, this timeout allows them to kind of slow down the pace, maybe set all the jitters at the beginning of the game as Pally came out firing early.
Yeah, they tie with a three, 4:53 to go here in the first.
It looks like Pally's continuing to press. They're now having everybody in the front court to basically force Lynbrook to make a lot of passes, maybe force a mistake.
Yada Turgut and Vivian Wu check in.
Pally's playing some really great zone defense. They're playing man. Lindbrook's trying to motion around the three-point line.
Tries a three, well contested. Good rebound inside. Shot is good and a foul. She goes to the stripe to tie this one up.
That was a really good job of working through the contact to make sure she still got the bucket and was able to still head to the free throw line for a chance at an and one.
Sarah Ho to the line to tie it up. As you see that again, just grabs the rebound against the bigger target, goes up strong, draws the contact.
Does a really good job of moving up her elbow to draw that contact and get to the line.
They are trying to break this Lynbrook press. Peters calling a play. Turgut goes to the bench.
Lynbrook's doing a really good job of pressing full court, making Pally really use up a lot of that shot clock.
Peters takes it herself, throws to the corner. Nice catch by Wu. Ball movement, Martin wide. Open layup, can't finish. She's not happy, neither is Coach Scott Peters. Here comes the press. Three ball, no good. Rebounded by Thea Anosh. Martin pulls it from distance. No good. Martin taking most of the shots. She got it again. Wu, but Ho hits the deck. Gathered in by Lynbrook.
They're basically trying to push the pace, and Pally's trying to force them around.
Deep three, no good. Rebounded by Thea Anosh.
It's a really good job of ball movement until the end from Lynbrook, trying to get Pally to make a mistake
Peters
defensively.
Martin, Anosh in the post. Back to Peters.
Pally's running a lot of plays up top to try and get it, maybe a screen and roll. Get one of their big men open in the paint.
Knocked away. Wu recovers. Knocked away again. Peters recovers. Layup blocked by the rim. She went right up and got nothing but the bottom of the rim. She's missed two open shots early.
Pally's coach seems to be yelling to get cover man. Pally looked a little confused on that last possession.
Three ball. No good. They've been shooting a lot of threes, has this Lynbrook Viking team. That one, no good. Pally has the ball. We are still all tied up.
Lynbrook's really instituting a really good press here, trying to force number two to use all of her energy. And so when she has to give it up once they get to half court.
Carly Martin. Through pass to Fisk. No good. They get the rebound. Peters buries it.
That was a really good job of being ready to set and fire. As if she had waited another second, a Lynbrook player could have gotten there and maybe contested.
And the press broken well again by Lynbrook. They've just been outrunning Pally, pushing the ball much faster. And they can get back and defend. Reach foul, no call. Peters finds Martin. Martin finds Peters again. Playing catch here. Martin sets the screen, rolls off it. Peters jumper, no good. Rebound. Big rebound, big finish.
Pally's really attacking the glass early and making sure they can get to it by boxing out early.
The press broken again. Down inside block. Turgut blocked it. Shaw loves it on the bench.
She did a really good job right there of making sure she could hit the ball, but also not make contact with the player.
Nice move. Takes it inside through contact. No, gets her own rebound. Has to get out of there. And it's taken with nothing but court in front of her. Delaney ball foul.
Lynbrook seems to be upset as she thought that was going to be a jump ball call, but the ref calls it a foul.
Madison Yee does not like the call. You see here, she took it, and I don't see a foul call either. She looked like she took that one right away.
Yeah, it looked, but it did. I could see where the ref is coming from. There was a little contact on the arm, but I don't think enough to warrant a foul call. Pally's setting up inbound play.
It's not a stack. It's a box out. They throw inside.
Pally ball.
Pally retains possession.
Let's see, is Pally going to try and run the same play again?
There's a substitution first. Elif Turgut comes in, and Carly Martin gets her first break.
Carly Martin's been playing very well in this game, pushing the pace, really getting Palo Alto early and often looks.
Throw out past the safety valve. Turgut still moving the ball. Ball. Turgut, three ball for Fisk. There's people on the ground inside.
Great
Pally
rebound.
Somehow gets it. Everyone's on the ground. Retained by Lynbrook. It's a one-on-three. She's going to want to slow the pace down for this one. Put a move on in the backcourt. They break free. Down by three here. Just over a minute 10 to go in the first.
Lynbrook's doing a really good job of moving the ball around, but Pally is making sure it stays outside that three-point line.
Goes inside. Reverse layup, no. She was blocked, got it back, missed the reverse.
Pally.
Fisk, Turgut.
It seems
Nosh
like
on the floor.
Pally's really not spreading the floor well, as they're keeping a lot of their players to one side of the floor. I think if they were able to get one player on the other side that could maybe shoot a three, it could be a really dangerous
Lydian
offense.
Ball missed a three, the game tying three. No good for Lydian Live.
We got it, less than 40 seconds left in the first quarter. Pally is up 13-10.
11-second differential. They will not get a 2-for-1.
Pally is trying to move it around, gets a screen up top, has the roller.
Peters foul. And that will reset the shot clock. And they will have 19.3 shot clock turned off. They go with a bigger lineup. Turgut comes in for Anosh.
Pally should really try and hold it for the last shot here, not give Lynbrook a possible chance to tie it up.
Shot clock turned off. Maybe they just hold it outside for 12 of those seconds and put on a move. They throw to the backcourt again, trying to use up as much time as possible. 16 seconds still, a one possession ball game.
Yeah, they're doing exactly what you said, Kieran, trying to waste some time, maybe put a move on them, get an open shot.
Shot clock at five, they go inside. 3 seconds, shot rolls out. That's going to do it for the first quarter.
Kieran, what did you see in that opening quarter from Pally coming out fast?
Pally came out of the gates red hot. The Vikings were crusading, and they lead by three.
Yeah, I really like how Pally was able to push the pace. And Pally was able to push the pace, but Lynbrook was able to respond by basically breaking the press and getting easy buckets at the rim. This game would be a lot bigger differential if Pally was able to hold that press.
Yeah, but one thing we've seen from both teams is they're not fouling. It was a very clean first quarter. Two for Lynbrook, just one for Pally. And Pally leads by three.
Yeah, I mean, both teams are playing very clean. Both teams are rotating well, especially on that block. The player made sure to stay, keep her body contact out of the way and just get that arm up when the ball went up.
Yeah. So for the Vikes, it's been mainly Carly Martin taking the shots with Kayla Peters. They've been going back and forth.
It'll be interesting to see for Pali, since they have a couple players taking the majority of the shots, if they're going to be able to keep that up throughout the game, or if maybe in the fourth quarter they're too tired, or they're going to have somebody else pick up the slack.
Yeah, Lynbrook is pressing a lot, and Pali's press just has not been working. As you said, Lynbrook's breaking the press every time.
Yeah, so it'll be interesting to see what adjustments Pali's going to be able to make and see if Lynbrook can make any adjustments maybe to prevent all the penetration in the lane.
Julian Lynn for the first time in. Julia Lynn for the first time is in for Lynbrook. The ball's on the deck. Turgut has it. Throws to Peters, and Pali pushes it strong up the far side. And the throw too long, out of bounds, Lynbrook basketball.
Yeah, what I'm seeing early is both teams are being really aggressive. You see teams diving for the ball all over the place. Nobody's just kind of letting it go. They both really want this bad to have sole possession of first place in the league.
Holding outside. Puts a move on. Throws, nobody there.
Yeah, that was a nice rotation to try and close off the passing lane and basically force her to try and make a harder pass and leading it to going out of bounds.
Yeah, it's a sloppy start. Two quick turnovers.
It seems like Lindbrook's maybe taking a slower approach to prevent all the penetration in the lane by holding off the press. Maybe they'll wait till a little later in the second quarter to reinstitute it.
There's a foul on Lynbrook there, third. 7:24 to go in this first half. Vikes by three.
Pali
inbounds to Delaney Ball playing catch with Kayla Peters. Peters goes right, has Martin, keeps it, finds Ball again. I beg your pardon, that's Turgut. Tries to find her sister, can't. Lynbrook has the ball.
That was a great positioning by the Lynbrook player. She was the smaller one of the two and had to basically get in the right position to stop that pass from getting in deep.
Ooh, she wanted that game tying three. Takes a contested two, not even close. Rebounded by Sarah Ho, Vikings basketball.
That was a great play, as the Lynbrook player assumed she was gonna get it very easily, and Pali using that aggressive nature to try and get the ball back.
Yeah, she did not take the three. Peters finds Martin, has it right side. Martin drives and scores.
That was a great play by number zero. Although she won't get an assist, she set up that play by screening the defender to get the wide open layup.
This Viking crowd into it a little bit now. They lead by five, that's their largest. Can Lynbrook answer? This Pali defense suffocating. Jump ball, Pali ball.
Pali's doing a really good job early of basically suffocating and forcing Lynbrook to make a decision and not allowing the open and quick shots.
Peters checks out. Inbounded to Martin. Knocked away, they had the break, they don't take it.
If they hurry, they can have it.
Ball, risky pass. Nice play by Martin to corral it.
I think they should feed number zero. She has a large height advantage.
If she has the height advantage, it will be Lynbrook ball. Down by five, they are in a bit of a scoring drought. They need a bucket.
Yeah, I think Lynbrook really needs a play to draw up, maybe take a timeout when you get down here to see if you can draw something up, get your offense back together. They have not scored this whole quarter.
Outside, nice move. Risky pass, knocked away. Lynbrook retains possession.
That was really good defense though by Pali. You saw one or two of their defenders basically getting in the passing lane, not allowing anything easy.
Let's see if they get something off this inbound.
Pally.
Julia Lynn to Linian Lee. Goes up inside, out of bounds. Vikings ball. And they're looking to push here, push this lead.
Scott Peters on the defensive end seems to be a little frustrated, maybe getting his players to position in certain ways. But I think they're doing an overall great job so far.
Gets to the cup off the hands of Elida Turgut. Bats out of bounds, Lynbrook ball. A very sloppy start to this second quarter. Only 2 points have been scored, and each team has a pair of turnovers.
Yeah, both teams came out firing in the first quarter. It slowed down a little more in the second quarter. Both teams are pulling off the press, basically just trying to play their game.
Pace lagging just a little bit, just over 5 minutes to play in this first half, and that's a foul as Haley Lee hit the deck, fouled by Delaney Ball.
Yeah, we can still see that aggressive and tenacious nature of both teams really wanting to go at it, but neither can really gain the advantage so far.
Yeah, as you said earlier, I think Lynbrook might need to call time, regroup just a little bit.
Yeah, I think Pali, if this could slowly turn into a Pali run, you get it up to 7, maybe even 8 or 10 points, it's a lot bit different than it is now.
That's what they needed right there. Inside, good finish, Allison Lai. Back to a 3-point game.
Yeah, we can see that maybe this will get Lynbrook going, as a lot of times teams, when they just see that ball go through the hoop, they get a lot of hope back. They can see that they really can score on this team and maybe get back in the lead.
Yeah, Pauly, this is their chance. They can keep extending. And Delaney Ball goes to the bench.
Yeah, what I really like in this game is that Pally's really forcing Lynbrook to play their style of basketball. When they're basically slowing it down now, not doing a lot of presses, and basically just forcing them to eat up the shot clock, not give Lynbrook as many possessions and go up and down the floor like they want to do.
Risky pass goes to Torres. 3-ball, air ball. Rebounded by Lynbrook, they have a chance to tie. Here come the Vikings. They're pushing both teams, the Vikings. Torres, the rebound. Jump ball, Lynbrook basketball. Julia Lynn took that ball right away from Itzel Torres. Lynbrook under the basket.
Mason Yee checking in for Allison Lee.
And Lynbrook needs a bucket. Vivian Wu checks out. Lynbrook needs a bucket. They can make it a 1-point game or tie.
It was a really well drawn up play. The pass was just a little late.
Jumper good.
Maybe that layup a couple minutes ago was just what Lynbrook needed to get their offense going. That's baskets on 2 straight possessions.
1-point game under 4 minutes to play.
That was a really nice crossover. Got the defender off her feet and was able to create a little space.
Peters to Torres. Back to Peters. Torres wants it back.
She's got number 34 in the post, but decides to pass it.
Anosh comes out, sets a screen. They want to give it to her back. Lynbrook tips it away. Torres control. Shot clock at 1. Deep 3. Chucked up. It's no good. Great defensive possession by Lynbrook. They're going to get it back with a chance. A bucket gives them the lead.
Yeah, I really liked the defense on the last possession. A lot of rotations, a lot of teamwork. If you basically try and play by yourself, it'll lead to a lot of open shots.
Holding. Inside. Outside. 3-ball. No good. Lynbrook grabs the rebound. Took it away. Pally takes it right back. That's Martin to Peters. Martin, Torres, 3-ball. No, and Nosh takes the rebound to Turgut. Torres inside, knocked away, Lynbrook ball.
That was a lot of great movement, especially by Torres, setting herself up in the corner, and then after the ball gets knocked out to the other side, cutting into the lane, possibly trying to get a layup. That was a really great play by Torres.
Anosh deep for Pally. They've changed their ways as Nosh sits all the way back because the press has been beaten too many times for Scott Peters' liking.
Yeah, I wonder how they change it. Are they playing more of a zone concept? Because earlier they were playing a man, seeing if maybe they can get a trap or something else.
Here they go, holding up top. We're under 3 minutes. Risky pass, Lynbrook tries a contested three and got it.
Lynbrook's really started off hot after getting that layup. They really just needed one to get their juices flowing, and now they're ready to roll.
7-0 run for Lynbrook, and thrown out of bounds. Too high for Peters. Lynbrook looks to extend this 1-point lead. But press still there. Peters guarding Yee. Yee moves it right. Crosses. Nice move. Hezzy.
I'm starting to think maybe if Lynbrook gets another basket on this possession, it's time for Scott Peters to take a timeout for his team. But Pally.
They do not. Pally has the ball going the other way. Peters. Or that's Martin, beg your pardon. Risky pass goes to Peters. Deep three, no. Rebound controlled by Lynbrook's probably a Yee.
Yep.
Yee. To Madison Yee.
Pally's really having a tough time on offense here and cannot seem to get a bucket as they haven't gone about 3 to 4 minutes without a bucket.
Anosh runs it down. Foot looked like it was on the line. It was not. Peters. Nope. Peters gets it back. Tries another three. This one no good too. And the putback no. Anosh third chance bucket no. And for the fourth offensive rebound, it's Fisk gets taken away. Lynbrook down Broadway. And a great foul. Very good foul by Alif Turgut. She had a bucket.
Are they going to call it a clear path foul?
They will not, as it will be inbounded under the basket.
I really think if Lynbrook scores here, maybe not waste it now since there's only a minute 20, but I think at halftime, Scott Peters and that the Vikings are going to have to make a lot of adjustments as Lynbrook has really seemed to figure out what they're trying to do defensively.
This ball movement is amazing for Lynbrook. They try a three. That could have been big rebounded. A big rebound. They go for a quick runner if they get the ball back. Vikings ball.
I really think this crowd noise is going to start becoming a factor as Pally needs to get the momentum back in this game. They really had control, and since Lynbrook's gone on this run, they haven't had a chance to really gain any of that momentum back.
1 minute to go in the half. Lynbrook by two, Vikings try to tie. Peters looks for Martin, can't find Martin. Peters retains her dribble, nice move. She throws to the post to Turgut. Turgut inside, finishes. We're tied at 17. 7 second differential. Lynbrook looks to push it though.
Lynbrook's really tried to basically take away Pally's inside game, which has been their bread and butter all game.
Look at this ball movement out of bounds. Lynbrook retains possession. 25 on the game clock, 18 on the shot clock. We're tied at 17, they'll inbound under the basket. It's been pretty much the same five, six players for Lynbrook. Open three didn't take it.
Yeah.
Back to Ho. Shot clock at 12, three ball. Bounce around, no good. Turgut. Pally has the chance to take the lead before the break. 10 seconds to go. Peters. Works on Lynn. Peters. Shot clock at 5. She wants to take this one herself. She gets a screen. It's a deep contested three off the rim. And Coach Peters will not be too happy about how they finished off that half. But we have a great game in store. Join us for the second half. And real quick, we will see that last point. It was a big one. The layup ties it, and oh, you see Turgut. That tied the game at 17 with 30 seconds to go. Stick around. We have a great second half coming up next. We're all tied up at 17. Welcome back, everybody, to Palo Alto, where we have a tightly contested contest between the Lynbrook Vikings and the Pally Vikings. 17-17 at the start of the third. It was a red-hot first quarter, as it was 13-10 Pally after the first quarter, and the second quarter, the pace really slowed down, and we're tied at 17-17 right now. What does Lynbrook have to do to win this game?
I really think they got to do exactly what they did in the second quarter, really trap Pally down on those posts and force them their big men to pass. Because as Pally has all the size in this matchup, if Lynbrook really allows them to control that block, it'll be easy buckets for Pally all day, and Lynbrook won't be able to do much about it. Kieran, how do you think Pally
can... It's a happy birthday being yelled from the cheerleaders. I am not sure what's going on here, but it's 17-17. We got a ball game, and we are just about to start the second half. Coach Peters was animate in his halftime huddle, telling his team to use the post, and he drew up a couple plays to get them wide open threes. Let's see if they can run those here in the second half. 17-17. Overtime is a possibility. They tied through the first half. Let's see if they do it for the second.
Yeah, I think the key for Pally, or for Lynbrook to really win this game, is to use their speed. As we've seen, whenever Pally tries to slow it down, Lynbrook tries to speed it back up. They can really get it consistently going at a fast pace. I think since Pally's really relying on a couple players to take the shots, it could tire them out. And when we get to the fourth quarter, if Scott Peters doesn't manage his rotations accordingly, we could see a very tired Pally team against a very fast Lynbrook team. And maybe they could stretch out their lead.
Yeah, so we are just about ready for the second half. Both teams are continuing with their first half starters. Peters and Martin were the stars, and Ho and Lee for Lynbrook. It's Pally ball at half court. And we are ready for the second half is underway. Peters up top. Hands off to his fist.
Yeah, it seems to me like Pally's trying to get a lot of that motion going again like they had in the first quarter, trying to get Lynbrook out of position, because Pally really seemed stagnant in that second quarter. That was a really good example of how Lynbrook was able to get out of position as a result of Pally's movement and got Pally an open shot.
Jump ball, it goes to Lynbrook, all tied at 17 early in the third.
Yeah, they gave the ball to Lynbrook off the jump ball, and they're going to bring it up now.
Pally did not press to start. Let's see what they do here.
The crowd is really getting into it now, as the cheerleaders can be heard around the world.
As a great play by Lynbrook to save it the first time, but it's thrown out of bounds.
Maybe the crowd noise taking effect here. Maybe Pally can use that energy and use that momentum to get on top here.
7:16 to go in the third quarter. Turgot and Peters playing catch in the backcourt. It's up to Martin. Long pass. Fisk. Three ball. In and out. No good. Martin wanted that one.
It looks like Lynbrook instituted back in their trap, their full court trap, to maybe speed up the game, force Pally's playmakers to make a mistake and keep the ball out of their hands of their big players.
Pally moving the ball. Martin has it. Has ball. One pass to Peters.
Yeah, as a result.
Back to ball. Back to Martin. They go inside to Turgot. Martin, three ball. No. Lynbrook gets the rebound. The ball is loose. Pally has it. Peters.
That was really great aggressiveness by both teams. Pally just had a little bit more than Lynbrook there.
The rebound by Lynbrook. They move the ball up the court with Madison Yee. Deep pass, three ball. It was open. It doesn't go. Rebounded by Carly Martin.
Yeah, Pally's really trying to get inside, but Lindbrook's doing a really good job in their zone of staying home, not over-rotating, and basically forcing Pally to take outside shots, which they...
And the three finally falls for Kayla Peters.
Yeah, I think that's going to be a big key in the second half. If they can start hitting the three ball, they'll maybe have to switch back out of that zone, back into man, get those bigger matchups. And it seems like Pally now has also switched to a zone.
Lynbrook, shot clock. No matter as the three is missed. Rebound did and pushed up the floor by Peters. Martin has it inside, target layup, good.
Another way that basically Pally can try and break this Lynbrook zone or the other way around is try and push the pace. If they can't get set up in their zone, then there's gonna be holes and easy baskets in them.
Ellis Turgut knocks that one right out of bounds. Pally leads by five. Lynbrook looks to cut into it.
Yeah, Pally's doing a really good job of managing their rotations, making sure they get everybody fresh and everybody in. Nobody seems to be lagging in this game on either side.
Everyone does look fresh. Let's see what happens. Nice move, three ball, it's a deep one, it's no good. That one did not look good at all. Pally looks to push to their largest lead. They lead by five right now. They go inside to Turgut, one move. Turgut's layup good.
That was a really good switch as the zone had rotated towards the block, leaving the lane wide open for a player to cut in and get the wide open layup.
Pally has the largest lead of the night at seven. And it's been the last seven, and it's been the last seven scored, the first seven of his second half. Lynbrook still has a zero in this second half. You see that missed three, a great rebound, and then Pally just pushes the pace. They go downstairs.
Yeah, they did a really good job of pushing the pace. Like I was saying earlier, it's when you're playing zone defense, it's a necessity for you to get set up in that zone because you think other players are going to be in a certain position. By pushing the pace, Lynbrook really wasn't able to get set up, and therefore they were able to create a hole in the defense and get a wide open layup.
Peters talked about ball movement. There were six passes before the bucket on the last possession. Lynbrook down by seven. They need some sort of spark. Seems like they've been playing from down all night long. Let's see if they can change that.
Kieran, what do you think the Lynbrook coach was saying to her team in that last timeout?
I mean, she's saying that we know we're a good team, and seven's not a lot. There's a lot of time to go, almost a full half. We're just as good a basketball team as them. Let's keep pushing, playing hard, and I have faith in this team to come back. Lynbrook, let's see what play they have coming out of a timeout.
Looks like they're trying to get number 23 the ball, but Pally denies it. Great defense.
They go inside, outside. The ball movement is electrifying for this Lynbrook team. Layup good.
Yeah, I think it's going to be key for both teams to see who can hit more outside shots because a lot of the it looks like a lot of the team's offense for both sides is coming in the paint. If they can get some players to stretch the floor by shooting threes or even deeper balls outside the paint, it'll be force the defense to stretch out and maybe open up more
right
shots inside.
Right off the hands of Carly Martin.
Looks like a foul on Pally and foul on Lynbrook. Palo Alto ball.
The call was jump ball, I think, was the call. It's Pally ball. She can't get the ball in.
Do we get a timeout? It appears there's a problem with the shot clock during the inbound. The ref is telling the scoreboard operator to reset it to a certain time. We're basically going to get a do-over here, folks.
The shot clock has
been reset to 10.
10 seconds as it hit the rim and came off. It is a rebound. Shot clock at 10. They throw it deep. Turgut knocked away. Pally retains possession, and now the shot clock's at 7.
Yeah, that was really great defense. You can see Lynbrook collapsing the lane, trying to get the ball out to the outside.
That's a great job. They force it to the outside. Shot clock at 3-2. Martin, triple. No.
That's a shot clock violation as it hit the top of the backboard, not the rim, to reset it. That'll be Lynbrook basketball.
3:38 to go in the third. 5-point Vikings lead, Lynbrook.
Looks like they're trying to screen up top, get some movement going, see if they can get Palo out of position.
But we have a Vikings chant raining down.
You can really hear the crowd getting into it at this point. The cheerleaders are becoming a big factor in this game, cheering on their girls.
Three ball. No, that would have been a big one. Turgut gets the rebound. Let's see if Palo can push. Lynbrook pressing well. They need to cross the backcourt line. They do. Knocked away. No foul call. Risky pass. Martin stares down. Pulls it. Triple. Vikings.
That was some really great offense by the Vikings. Getting the ball around, pushing the advantage while Lynbrook wasn't able to get back. Great job by Martin there, being ready to fire when asked.
Martin buries a three. Ho on the other end tried to answer and couldn't. Pass, it was a save. It's stolen by Peters. They're pushing the pace and pushing the pace well. They go to the corner. She wanted to take that three. Big layup, good.
Pally's on
and
a really.
And Pally has a double-digit lead.
I think Lynbrook really needs to call a timeout here. They're in a deep hole, and if Palo gets the ball and scores again, this game could be over soon.
The We Are the Vikings chant raining down from the Palo cheerleaders. The ball is in the hot hand of Carly Martin, goes inside. Turgut finishes.
I think Lynbrook desperately needs a timeout. Slow this game down, get it back to playing their game, because as long as this clock keeps running, the Palo lead keeps growing.
It's a 14-2 Palo run in this third quarter.
Do you think the adjustments at halftime are the difference here, Kieran?
Yes, I do. Coach Peters had something to say to his basketball team. Lynbrook stops the run with a bucket.
Yeah, I think they really need to slow down the pace as Lynbrook is continually getting broken on the press, not being able to set up their defense, which is what helped them in the second quarter.
Offensive foul on Turgut.
Yeah, maybe that basket and this offensive foul will allow Lynbrook to gain a little momentum, gain another basket, maybe make it a single-digit game before the end of the third quarter.
Scott Peters wanted an explanation for that one, and he seemed to get one that satisfied him. The call was Turgut lifted her arm, causing that offensive foul.
Yeah, we've had a lot of great reps in this game. We haven't seen a lot of really bad missed calls, and I think that's good for both sides. Pally's doing a really good job here of communicating, making sure their teammates know exactly where they are, who they have, and all to make sure they can get the rebound, play good defense.
Layup rolls home. We have 1 minute and counting. Lynbrook with a steal. This could be their ticket right back into this one. They're down by 8. A risky pass corralled by Lynbrook in the backcourt. 50 seconds to go in the third.
I think it was really big there on that last offensive possession for Lynbrook to be able to cut it to single digits. There's a big difference in just the mental state of a team when it's a double-digit versus single-digit lead.
And there it is. They're right back in the ball game. They're down by 6. It's a two-possession game. And we have a 5-second differential between the two clocks. Martin makes a move in the backcourt. Right down Broadway. Vikings retain possession.
Martin a little mad at a no-call there. Thought she got fouled. She thinks she should be going to the free throw line. But it appears the ref just calls it out of bounds off Lynbrook.
5-second differential will be hard for Lynbrook to get a bucket if Palo runs it to nothing. Time out called, 6-point game, and this one could be going down to the wire.
Yeah, I really, on this replay, you can see how Lynbrook drives and gets the nice little floater to go in before the defense can collapse.
Yeah, a nice bucket there to get them back within 2 possessions. There's 26 on the game clock, 21 on the shot clock. Palo leads Lynbrook by 6. Palo called that last timeout. Neither team is even near the bonus. It's been a very, very clean game. The turnover is the only issue. Very few fouls And, of course, there has only been one free throw attempted by either team, and that was made by Pally.
Yeah, Kieran, we were talking about before the game how we thought Lynbrook was going to be able to come in here, speed up the pace, and really take control of this game. But it seems like Pally slowed it down, used their size to their advantage. What do you think is the main difference and why Pally's leading this game right now?
I think it's the size. They are using their size advantage very well. Turgut inside there, winning the rebounding battle by a lot. Let's see what Coach Peters comes up with out of a timeout. They just go straight up to Turgut. Martin.
I think they're going to try and institute a strategy they used in the first half, kind of let a lot of the clock run, not give Lynbrook another chance at a shot.
Peters goes to Anosh. Turgut. Martin. Clock at three. Peters triple. No. That's going to do it.
It appears there's a little confusion among the refs if the ball hit the rim or not. It appeared the ball did, and I'm not sure why they stopped play.
4.2 seconds to go. Pally inbounds under their own basket, trying to stretch it to a three-possession lead.
Pally's running a stack play, trying to get the defense discombobulated, gets it in.
Anosh throws one up quickly. Turgut, they just can't foul. One, that's going to do it. Anosh puts one up, it goes in, but time has expired. We have the fourth quarter on the way. 6-point Pally Vikings lead. You think they hold on to this win at home, Austin?
I think they will, mostly because this home crowd, as the game has gone on, has gotten more and more involved. And I think if they can stay involved, if they can slow down the pace like they have and basically play that collapsing defense, they'll be all good, as they've been. But I'm more interested to see if the scoring overall just slows down in the fourth quarter, because, you know, like much like the first quarter, this was both teams came out fast and firing with lots of points, but then the coaches went in, made some adjustments, and slowed down the game.
And Peter's adjustments were obviously just a little bit better. Winley Takai, you saw her there talking to her Lynbrook Vikings, and they are still very much in this game. I think they need to move a little bit away from the three shooting. They were doing that a lot in the first few periods. But now, the second they stopped shooting the three and they just started hitting their open layup, they have been cruising and getting themselves back in the game.
Yeah, I agree with you. I think both teams really need to attack inside, but they both need to have that outside threat to basically hit the ball and make the defense respect the outside shot, so they can't just play five in the paint and basically not allow layups.
Fourth quarter underway. Lynbrook has the basketball and a chance to make it a one-possession ball game. They take it into the backcourt.
Yeah, Pally's still playing that really good defense, but that's a great switch for Lynbrook as they get the taller
defender. Three ball, no, that's a big offensive rebound. The ball movement. They try another three. No good. They seem to lean on the three a bit too much, and it is not falling for them.
Yeah, if their shots begin to fall, this could be a totally different ball game, as Lynbrook really is using their speed to try and get around the three-point arc, maybe use their speed, get Pally out of position, and get a free drive. But Pally's been playing good, disciplined defense and not allowing that to happen.
Yeah, that was a very deep three attempted on the last one. Pally under the basket. Good catch by Peters on the left side. Wants to make a move. Looks for Anosh in the post.
Yeah, it's really good for Pally to basically stay home because Lynbrook is so much faster. And they can, if they get out of position, it's pretty much over, as Lynbrook is so quick. It looks like a foul on
Lynbrook, as the Vikings will inbound again. Shot clock at 8.
Peter's getting another explanation.
Thrown out deep to Martin.
They reset the shot clock to 30.
Let's see how much of a shot clock they use. Peters, good ball movement. Martin, it's all outside. Peters, triple, no. Rebounded by Lynbrook. And well played, a jump ball. Pally gets it right back.
That's a great use of aggressiveness and trying to get that extra possession, really showing that they want this game more than Lynbrook right now.
Yeah, Elif Turgut took that one right back for her team. Shot clock resets to 30, and they'll inbound under the basket again.
Yeah, it was a great, great aggressiveness, showing that they really want it. And it looks like it is a jump ball. I'm wondering what the refs are discussing right now. As we can see on this replay, she kind of turns into the Pally player, and she just kind of grabs on and holds on and gets the jump ball call.
Anosh checks out. And another, they throw all the way back to the cutting safety valve. That's Martin in this case.
Yeah, it seems like both teams' inbound plays really haven't been working tonight. It seems like a lot of them have been forcing to pass out to the safety valve.
Three ball, Peters, air ball. Martin with the save. She saved it out of bounds, though.
Yeah, I think it's really interesting how both teams, or Potley's trying to move their center up to around the elbow at the free throw line to basically get Lynbrook's center defender to move up, maybe create holes behind her.
Oh, a risky pass that's picked off by Carly Martin. 6:30 to go. A risky pass, Peters with a leaping catch against the sideline.
Both teams in this game have had a lot of really great ball movement, keeping the defense on their feet, not really making one player beat them.
The movement, shot clock under 10, Turgut inside, posting up. They kick it outside. D3 for Peters, no. Rebounded by Carly Martin, shot clock resets. Turgut inside, no, this time rebounded by Lynbrook.
Yeah.
Goes ahead.
Both teams, after making their adjustments, have really played well in the defensive end, slowed it down. So far, we haven't had a bucket, and I expect that to continue with the strong defensive play.
Yeah, as well done by Madison Yee. She drew a foul on this one.
First free throws of the game for Lynbrook. And that was a miss. Keeping the score at 31, Palo Alto, to 25, Lynbrook. Scott Peters just making a lot of great rotational adjustments right now, maybe saving his starters for a little later in the game so they're fresh and ready to go, as he thinks this is going to come down to the wire. Makes the second one, and Pally is pushing the pace. They're playing really good defense, not allowing them to get any space. And Pally, although Pally's trying to move around, they're not really having any success right now. Keeping the ball in number one's hands.
And stolen by Lynbrook. Right down Broadway. They need this layup to fall, and it does. Lynbrook back within a possession. 5:15 to go.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see if Pally, some of Pally's reserves can pick up the slack, as a lot of the starters left. And we'll see if Pally can basically keep their momentum going, or Lynbrook can climb back into the lead.
Pally needs a bucket, and that one's not going to go. Lynbrook has it with a chance to tie. They move the ball up the court. They go inside. It's good. One-point game. We got a ball game here in Palo Alto.
Yeah, Lynbrook's really starting to use their speed again, not letting Palo Alto use that size over them, and basically playing hard and playing fast.
Pally moving the ball. They look, they get inside. Layup, no foul. Lynbrook with a bucket takes the lead. They slow it down just a little bit. Oh, 4:18 to go in the ball game. Peters directing traffic from the sideline. Handoff. Pass to the corner. She's inside. That's a risky pass taken away by Carly Martin. Pally can push the lead right back up. Martin, triple, no good. Rebounded off the foot of Anosh. It's in the corner, picked up. And off the knee, Pally basketball.
I think that was a big call right there, as Pally can really try and get a little more of an advantage here, or possibly Lynbrook could take the ball and go down and take the lead.
Pally can take a little bit of time off this clock.
I don't think that's the way they should attack it right now. Is only having a 1-point lead, you can't play like you're trying
Peters,
not to lose.
Nice pump fake. Martin gets inside, layup good.
That was a great play by number zero to basically fend off the defender and create the open lane.
Yeah, great play by Chirgit. Lynbrook on the other end. Moving the ball well. They want to take a three and tie this one up.
Yeah, they're trying to look for the three. I think the right way to go about this is go for two. But yeah. I mean, if the three is open there, take it. They haven't been hitting these all game. I think it's a risky.
Shot clock under 10. They're going to try a triple. It's no good. Out of bounds to the Vikes. 3:18 to go. They lead by three. Do they push for two possessions or run this one under 3 minutes, Austin?
I think they're going to play their game. I don't think they're going to worry about the clock at this point in the game. There's still a lot of time. There's still a lot could happen. We could have a team win by 10. We could have a team win by one. We don't really know at this point in the game.
Yeah, we are in for a thriller of a finish. The Vikes holding up top. That's Turgut. Turgut posting up. Turgut goes up strong. Turgut finishes.
That was a
nice by five. Lynbrook wants timeout.
That was really big as Turgut used her size to go up over the smaller Lynbrook defender, giving a little fake and then going up for the wide open layup.
2:48 to go, 5-point game. Look at this big Turgut layup again. Extends the lead to a couple possessions. 2:48 to go. Under 3 minutes is the clock. Any bit of a factor for either team at this point, Austin? If you're Lynbrook, are you trying to get a quick shot or just any shot?
I think at any shot. You still got 2 minutes and 48 seconds. That could be anywhere from, 12 to 15 possessions. There's still a lot of possessions left in this game, and if you're really thinking about two or three, I think you're focused on the wrong thing here, and you really just need to focus on playing your game, making a minor adjustment, maybe getting a basket here or there, but I don't think here is the time to decide two or three.
Lynbrook has the ball. They need any sort of a bucket. They have the press beat. No, they don't.
Yeah, that was a great adjustment by Pauly, basically having more in the backcourt, but still forcing the hard pass from Lynbrook.
Lynbrook shot clock at 18. They have gotten no open looks lately. They go outside. They try to go inside. Oh, that was a... They are lucky they retained that one. Jumper, no rebound. That's going to reset the shot clock. It's outside. It's a triple. It's open. It's good.
That was really big. As
nothing but the bottom of the net. It's a 2-point game.
Yeah, I think that was a really big shot in this game as they were down five, needed a two and a three to tie it up. And Lynbrook's threes have not been falling throughout the game. So that was a really, really big shot to get it down to two.
That was a Captain Lydian Lee. Peters inside, takes it into her own hand. Lynbrook has the ball, leads with the three, ties with the two. Oh, we got a ball game. She wanted to shoot that.
Kieran, if you're Lynbrook here, do you go for a two or a three?
It's a risky pass. It's an open three. It's no good. Big rebound. Big rebound, Carly Martin.
Yeah, I think this is a really big possession. As, if Pauly wants to, they can really take down the clock to a little over a minute, put two possessions left in the game. But if they don't score, this could give Lynbrook the opportunity to go down and score and take the lead.
Both targets on the floor with Delaney Ball, Martin, and Peters. It's Martin. Shot clock. Under five, way up, good!
That's a big call as Lynbrook calls for timeout. Now, if you're Lynbrook going down the floor here, do you take a two to get it down to two, or do you take a three, basically forcing them, unless they hit a three on your end, to make it a one possession game?
I say you take the first open shot you can get. At this point, they need a pretty quick bucket, and Ellie Turgut has had some big buckets in this game, but no bigger than the one you see there. She finishes strong to give her team a 4-point lead. But as you were saying before, I think Lynbrook just takes what they can get if they get an early open three, or if they can get downstairs and score. I think they take what they can get. 4-point game, 1:12 to go. The Pauly Vikings lead by four. Again, 1:12 to go. Lynbrook has the ball, down four. They have two timeouts. Pauly has three. Two fouls for Pally, 1 for Lynbrook. So that should, bonus should not be a factor in this last minute.
Yeah, I think one big thing Scott Peters has been got to tell his team right now is do not bite on a fake three. You cannot give up free throws at this point in the game for some easy missed shot. I think that's, they got to play smart, they got to play disciplined, and not give up an open shot and let Lynbrook really try and push the pace, maybe get two scores very quickly here.
Yeah, Pally drops two, presses three, and immediately drop back 1:10 to go. They need a bucket and they need one quick.
Yeah, I really like how Pally's playing this. They went back to their man, leaving three balls open.
Three, got it! Big three ball, we got a ball game! My goodness! Yeah. Woody and Lee!
Yeah, we got a serious ball game, and if you're Scott Peters, who do you go to in this time? Do you call a timeout? Do you draw up a play, or do you just let your, do you just trust your players to go out and make a bucket?
At this point, you have to trust your team. Martin, Turgot, Peters, they've all come with clutch buckets time and time again this season and this game. 41 seconds. Lynbrook fouled. It means nothing at this point. Two fouls there. A long way from the bonus.
Who do you go to in this spot?
I got to go to Carly Martin.
Yeah, she's been playing a great game, and she's gotten shot
Martin
after
with
shot
the
to
screen.
Drop.
That could have been a moving screen, no call. 1 point game, a three is the dagger. Turgot puts on a move, gets inside, throws to her sister. Martin, Turgot gets inside, layup blocked. Lynbrook has the basketball. 20 seconds, shot clock turned off. This is the ball game right here.
Wide open three.
It's a three ball. No good. Who's going to get this rebound? Carly Martin has it.
They got her trapped.
And that's going to do it.
She gets the timeout.
That's going to do it. That's most likely going to do
it. It's not over yet. We could see a Lynbrook steal off the inbound, maybe a quick basket. We don't know yet. This game is not over, folks.
That. And you look at this again. This big three there, that brought it back to one, and that's where we sit right now. 37-36. And now Lynbrook with 7.4. It's gonna be hard, but they just need to foul immediately. They need to foul them three times. Let them shoot their free throws.
Well, Kieran, what do you think you would do here? If you got him trapped in the corner, do you let a little time run off and try
shove him? Gotta shove him.
You gotta shove him. You gotta take the foul, preserve the clock, and play a little free throw game.
Okay, there's 7.4 here. If I'm Scott Peters, I run a play. You throw it as far into the backcourt as you can. You just get as far away, and then if you're Lynbrook, you just have to foul immediately, and then just run it back three times and hope you have a chance to throw up a prayer.
I think you try, if you're Scott Peters, you try and get it into your best free throw shooter. I don't think you try and throw it in the backcourt because that's too risky. I think you trust your best player.
And you see that now as they're going with all, they are going with the all good, with the all sharp shooter team. No center on the floor.
Yeah, it looks like they're trying a modified stack play.
They can't get the ball in. Martin can't get the ball in. Peters wants time again.
That was a great job by Martin to basically recognize that they're going to get a turnover, call a timeout. That's a great job by Peters, making sure his team was aware of what they could do.
Yeah, Peters called that timeout. He saw that they were going nowhere.
Yeah, it was a really, really important play in this game because if they turn it over, they're already on that side of the floor. Lynbrook has an easy opportunity to win this game. That's a really smart coaching adjustment by Scott Peters.
Okay, so real quick, I want to talk to you about a play, just the last play where Lynbrook decided not to call time and run a two-point or three-point play to win it. They just let their team push up the floor. Thoughts on that? It turned into a broken play three. Should they have called timeout?
I don't think so. I think at that time they had the advantage, they had the momentum, they had the numbers.
But also they had 20 seconds to go. They could have run so many plays and called timeout and run them again.
I agree with you, but I also think when you have the advantage, you just got to take that chance and trust your players. And unfortunately for them, it didn't work out there, but they still have a chance in this game. It is not over yet.
They need a steal and to call time or to foul them a lot in 7 seconds.
If you're Lynbrook,
box, it comes in and the foul immediately.
Takes about
6.2.
Yeah, it takes off about 1.2 seconds from the clock. We're not in the bonus yet, so this is really hard on Lynbrook because they're going to need to foul a couple more times, taking more time off the clock.
They need two or three more fouls to get this one.
There seems to be a little confusion between Scott Peters and the referees.
Scott Peters said that his player was hit around the neck area, hit in the back of the head, hooked a little bit. He wants there to be a technical or a flagrant call, but it's not going to happen.
Yeah, I think that would be a really big call at this point in the game, giving the Vikings possession and free throws, but it does not like the ref. The ref cared much for his appeal.
Here we go again. They get the ball in again. It's loose. Oh, and a foul. A foul, 4.7 to go. And this might be a miss the second situation, especially with the height advantage they'll have on the rebound.
Yeah, I agree. If they get to the free throw line, since they'll probably only be about 3 seconds left when they go to the free throw line, I don't think there'll be enough time if they miss the free throw for Lynbrook to get the rebound, call a timeout, and get down the floor.
And Lynbrook out of timeouts.
Yeah, so I think this is a really big inbound because I think this is really Lynbrook's last chance to get a steal, maybe a bucket.
And now Coach Takaki wants there to be a – she did not like the foul call on this one. They are getting time. They're getting time to run a play. Scott Peters yelling it to his team.
It looks like the Lynbrook coach is actually asking for time to be put back on the clock, and since the ref is talking to the scoreboard operator, maybe she is going to get her wish. I think the crowd's really got to get into it right now. This is the time where their team really needs them, and they are just quiet. Kieran, what are your thoughts on that?
Let's see. I think they're going to put five. Maybe they're going to put a full 5 seconds on the clock. Let's see what they do. And he goes over to explain to Scott Peters. Let's see what is put back on the clock. At this point, it is still sitting at 4.7. They're a foul away.
It seems like all is okay and does not look like they're going to put any time back on the clock. I wonder what they were talking about. Maybe was it fouling or certain rule, or I'm not sure. What do you think, Kieran?
I'm not sure. I think they are talking about the time, but just Takaki's wants more time. Peters, of course, does not want more time. And they're going to put 5.1. They're going to put 5.1 on the clock. This is going to be a big stoppage.
Pally,
they get the ball, and there's a foul. And a little clock ran. I think they need to take some time off again.
Yeah, I think that was a great notice by Takaki. That was a big play because that extra point four allows maybe for another foul to occur and maybe still have a chance for the
this
the
should be
Lynbrook.
The foul to get them into the bonus. There it is, 3 point. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. So much time bled off the clock.
Lynbrook is in just dismay about the amount of time that's coming off this clock, you know, as a Pally crew running the scoreboard.
Some time has to be put back on. Over a second and a half, but over a second, but off that clock, I think, after the foul.
Yeah, I think this is really big, and it's interesting. I wonder if it's 6 fouls to put them in the bonus. They put more time back on the clock, bring
it
back
up
to 3.2.
Let's say there's a foul here. That will put us maybe at 2.5-ish. They can't get the ball in. There it is. 2.3. Again, maybe a few points of a second can be put back on.
That's interesting. Are they not – what's the rule? Are they not in the bonus yet with 7 fouls?
One more. I think it is one more. I think it's 8. No. 2.3. They will be shooting three throws.
And timeout awarded to Lynbrook. Maybe discussing strategy on the free throws. This will give Scott Peters a decision whether he wants his player to go for the two.
And in comes all the centers. This is a gutsy. This is a very big decision for Peters. At this point, do you just make both? Force them with 2.3 seconds, no timeouts, to throw in full court and chuck a three?
I think you make two just because it's basically the same chance in my mind that they chuck up some three off the rebound and make it versus them getting it inbounded. I just think the amount of time that's going to run off the clock, because actually they don't have a timeout anyway. So it's basically the same difference. So I really think you just make two, so that way if by some chance they make the long distance three, it's a tie ball game, you go to overtime, you don't leave anything up to chance.
Here we go. 1 point game, 2.3 to go. Pally to the stripe. It's Jessica Fisk shooting the three throws of her young career.
It appears to me that maybe Pally told, or Scott Peters told her to go for make both. As they have two players back, maybe playing the long distance.
The first one's missed. It's a 1-1. That's going to do it. They break half court. Takaki wants a foul call. Hold on.
That was a very smart call by Peters, maybe to get a foul. But it looks like the refs are going to say it was after the whistle.
That's going to do it. A bit of a controversy filled last 2 minutes, but this one is over. Palo Alto Vikings take down the Lynbrook Vikings, 37-36. And it was a great game coming down to a controversial last few minutes. We'll look at the best plays from tonight's battle. You see, of course, that three and Turgot got two big shots down low.
Yeah, I think a lot of these were big plays in Pally's, shifting the momentum, making sure they could win this game, really keeping it to playing their game and not letting Lynbrook, the better team, take over.
And inside they go to, and that was a big three by Carly Martin. And of course this layup made it a 2-point game. And then when they stretched the floor, this was early in the second half, Carly Martin came up with very many clutch shots in this one.
Yeah, I think one big difference in this game is Lynbrook depended on the three a lot, and they just were not falling tonight. It'd be a very different story if Lynbrook could have gotten their three ball to go down.
And what are your thoughts just on the last 2 minutes?
I thought it was very controversial. There was a lot of time coming off the clock.
There was a lot of time off the clock, as you said. There was a foul call that everyone wanted with 0.5 to go down there in the corner. Takaki did not seem happy on almost any of the plays.
Yeah. I mean, I think it was the big difference was really that last couple minutes. The fact that basically they actually didn't foul. They played good basketball throughout the game, and it ended up hurting them in the end because they couldn't get into the bonus with enough time left.
Thank you, everybody, for watching, and you guys were in for a good one. Your final score from Palo Alto, Lynbrook falls to Palo Alto, 37-36. For Austin May and our entire crew here, thank you, everyone, for watching. I've been Kieran Costa. Have a great Tuesday night, and thank you for listening.